Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to the channel. So let's talk about our last stint on the dyno. Things went really awry. Nothing went as planned. And I don't know, man. It's really strange. The whole thing went really, really odd to lose 40 horsepower on the dyno. And so let's just clear the water. I reached out to Ben Kellmer about that and in a text, and I have a chain of texts from him I keep that I ask some questions. And basically I asked about changing gear sets on what is the gear set, what was the weight of the gear set, would I lose horsepower? And he says, no, the billet gears are lighter and you're gonna reduce rotating mass. And he also said, look for your horsepower somewhere else. So, okay, great. I totally get that. And I trust in what he's saying. So I'm just, I don't know. I don't know where to go with this. This is really, really, you know, I took a big hit on this. So I'm not so much concerned about the Granatelli coil packs. I'm concerned about where did my 40 horsepower go. That's what I'm concerned about. So what are we gonna do? We are gonna cross-check. We've cross-checked before on a DynaJet at Strictly Performance, and we got a 448 on the car. And we actually got more torque in that dyno. I will post a link in this video for that dyno. So now we are back on 93, but we do know what our 93 number is with the ported intake, which is 437. We only gained 12 horsepower from the E85 tune. So we're gonna go back to Strictly Performance. We haven't ran a gas tune there, but we ran the gas tune at our first, you know, dyno session at Force Engineering there. Just as our, you know, full dyno, E85, full bolt on, we got a 449. We went over to Strictly Performance, we got a 448. So one horsepower difference, that's, excuse me, that's totally matched up. So if we go knowing that we got a 437 on our first dyno after the port with 93 octane, we should see a 437 at Strictly Performance. I'm really curious to see what happens. If we get low numbers there, then I don't know. I don't know what to do, right? I don't know where to, to be honest with you. I think, you know, that I think something went wonky on that dyno. So guys, that's what we're gonna do. We got some warm weather coming up still into November, 60 degrees. So I'm gonna get one dyno session set up. We're just gonna take the gar there, put it on the dyno and see what numbers we get, because this totally went sideways for me, totally. And I want to get it straightened out. I'm gonna see what the hell's going on, because is the car, is it the dyno, what is it? It just, I took a big hit. I took a big hit. So anyways, that's it, that's it. We're gonna try and clear this up. And thanks guys, thanks for watching, and like and subscribe. So have a great day, take care.